Hello friends, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Professor S.P. Singh from Faculty of Management Studies, Gurukul Kangdi University, Haridwar. Today, we are going to study Module 36 on Narrative Analysis. After finishing this module, you will be able to know narrative analysis, understand analysis of narrative interviews, know narrative data, understand objective hermeneutics, understand further developments, and understand social science hermeneutics. Narrative analysis concentrates on the manners in which people bring into existence and apply stories to provide meaning to the world. It does not regard narratives as stories that communicate a group of facts concerning the world and is basically not interested in whether stories are true or not. Narrative analysis are viewed as social products people produce in the context of specific social, historical, and cultural places of settlements. They are seen as interpretative devices through which people represent themselves and their worlds to themselves and to others. Analysis of narrative interviews. The literature gives various guidelines for the analysis of narrative interviews. In the process of analysis, the beginning stage is to draw out all passages not giving an account of connected events from the text. Then the pure narrative text is broken down for its formal sections. A description involving structure of the contents is the next step. Then various components of the narratives are briefly referred. The abstraction involving analysis goes out from the clearly defined details of each part of life. The objective is to detail the sequence of life history in the periods of individual life up to current dominant structure concerned to a process. The analytic abstraction moves away from the specific details of the life segments. Instead, its intention is to elaborate the life historical sequence of experience in the individual life periods up to the presently dominant structure relating to a process. After the reconstruction of patterns of process, other non-narrative parts of the interview are integrated into the analysis. Finally, a comparison is made of the case analysis produced in this way. The aim is more to reconstruct the interrelation of factual process courses than to reconstruct the narrator's subjective interpretations of his or her life. The next step is the identification of the sequential, thematic, and the attachment of quotations explaining it. Finally, the core of the biography with the chief statements of the interview is designed. Paraphrases of statements from the text and the interpretation of the texts and surroundings of the interviews, especially of social and cultural nature, lead to further abstraction. After briefing the case stories to core stories, they are classified into types of processes. These types are related to life world milieus. This procedure also reconstructs the course of the biography from the course of the narrative. This reconstruction of factual courses from biographical narratives starts from the fundamental similarity. Narrative data. Bude suggests reconstruction of life constructions from the data contained in narratives and their analysis. He thinks that narratives include subjective and social construction in life constructions in narrative interviews. Brunner also understands life histories as social constructions. In their real forming, they draw on fundamental cultural narratives and the life histories the culture offers. The goal of analyzing narrative data is less to reconstruct factual processes rather than disclose these constructive processes. However, there is a difference between a life story told in the interview and the life history lived by the interviewee. Their analysis of narrative interviews contains five stages. The social data of the family are rebuilt from the narrative interpreted with respect to the scope of decisions compared to the actual decisions. Then a hypothesis is formulated and tested in the interpretation of the case of the family studied. General to all the procedures for analyzing narrative data is that in the interpretation of statements, the researcher begins from the pattern of the narrative. The statements are viewed in the context of the way the narrative proceeds. Furthermore, they include a formal analysis of the material indicating which passages of the text are narrative passages and which other parts of the text can be classified. The procedures differ in the way they view the role of the narrative in the analysis of relations being studied. Narratives are also seen as a special form of constructing events. This form can be found in everyday life. The knowledge and the mode of construction are specifically acceptable to research purposes. A characteristic feature of narrative analysis is the combination of formal analysis and sequential procedure in the interpretation of constructions of experiences. The theoretical background provides the direction to the analysis of subjective meaning. For this purpose, narrative interviews are used for collecting data. Research questions focus on the analysis of biographical processes. Cases are usually selected gradually and generalizations made in order to develop theories. Therefore, case analyses are compared with one another. The influence of the presentation of narration is underestimated. However, the possible inference from narrative to factual events in life histories is overestimated. Only in very rare examples are narrative analysis combined with other methodological approaches in order to overcome their limitations. Objective hermeneutics. The approach has been applied for analysis of all kinds of documents, including works of art and photographs. Objective hermeneutics was originally formulated for analyzing natural interactions such as family conversations. The general extension of the domain of objects of inquiry based on objective hermeneutics is expressed by the fact that authors characteristically understand the world as text. In the beginning, the aim was concentrated on the reconstruction of objective meaning structures of texts. Analysis in objective hermeneutics was interested in what the text producers thought, wished, hoped, or believed when they produced their text. Subjective intentions linked to text are held to be irrelevant in this context. The only relevant thing is the objective meaning of the text in a particular linguistic and interactive community. Analysis in objective hermeneutics must be strictly sequential. One must follow the temporal course of the events or the text in conducting the interpretation. They should be conducted by a group of analysts working on the same text. First, the members define the case to be analyzed and the level it is to be located. It could be defined as a statement or activity of a specific person or of someone who performs a certain role in an institutional context or of a member of the human species. This definition is followed by a sequential rough analysis aimed at analyzing the external context in which a statement is embedded in order to take the influence of such contexts into account. The focus of this rough analysis is mainly on considerations about the nature of the concrete action problem for which the studied action or interaction offers a solution. First, case structure hypotheses which are falsified in later steps and the rough structure of the text and of the case are developed. The specification of the external context or the interactional embedding of the case serves to answer questions about how the data came about. Under the heading of interactional embedding, the different layers of the external context of a protocol action sequence must be specified with regard to possible consequences and restrictions for the concrete practice of interaction itself, including the conditions of producing the protocol as an interactional procedure. The central step is the sequential fine analysis. This entails the interpretation of interactions on 9 levels as exhibited in Exhibit 1. At levels 1 and 3 of the interpretation, an attempt is made to reconstruct the objective context of a statement by constructing various possible contexts in thought experiments and by excluding them successively. At this stage, the analysis of the subjective meanings of statements and actions plays a minor role. Interest focuses on the structures of interactions. The procedure at level 4 is oriented to interpretations using the framework of conversation analysis, whereas at level 5, the focus is on the formal linguistic features of the text. Levels 6 to 8 strive for an increasing generalization of the structures that have been found. These figures and structures are treated as hypotheses and are tested step by step against further material. The elaboration of general structures from interaction protocols can be shown in the following steps in the proceedings of sequential fine analysis. First, the objective meaning of the first interaction is reconstructed. Therefore, the research group narrates stories about as many contrasting situations as consistently fit a statement. At the next step, the group compares general structural features to the contextual conditions in which the analyzed statement occurred. The meaning of an action can be reconstructed through the interplay of possible contexts in which it might have occurred and the context in which it actually occurred. In thought experiments, the interpreters reflect on the consequences that the statement they have just analyzed might have for the next turn in the interaction. They ask what could the protagonist say or do next? This produces a variety of possible alternatives of how the interaction might proceed. Then the next actual statement is analyzed and compared to those possible alternatives which might have occurred. By increasingly excluding such alternatives and by reflecting on why they were not chosen by the protagonists, the analysts elaborate the structure of the case. This structure is finally generalized to the case as a whole. For this purpose, it is tested against further material from the case. More generally, Ridge outlines three variants of text explanation in the research using objective hermeneutics. The detailed analysis of a text at eight different levels in which the knowledge and the external context and also the pragmatics of a type of interaction are explained in advance and are borne in mind during the analysis. The sequential analysis of each individual contribution to an interaction step by step. This is done without clarifying in advance the internal or external context of the utterance. This is the most demanding variant of objective hermeneutics, since it is very strongly based on the methodological premises of the overall concept. The full interpretation of the objective social data from all those who participate in an interaction before any approach is made to the text to be interpreted. This variant handles the fundamentals of a theory of the hermeneutics interpretation very flexibly and uses them in a rather metaphorical way. Further developments. Further, this procedure was developed for analysis of routine language mutual influence as material for interpretation available in recorded and transcribed form. The sequential analysis goes in quest for rebuilding the layers of social meanings from the process of the actions. If the empirical material is available in the form of tape or video recording and has a transcript, the material can be analyzed one stage after the other from beginning to end. Therefore, the analysis always begins with the opening connected series of the interaction. The events and processes are not always reported by the interviewees arranged in order of time. This creates problem in the process of analyzing interviewees with this approach. For example, interviewees may recollect a certain stage in their lives and then refer during their narrative to events happened much earlier. In the narrative interview also, there is no sequential arrangement in the narration of events and experiences. For analyzing interviews with the help of sequence analytic method, the researcher first has to make over the sequential order of the story from the assertions of the interviewees. Therefore, the events reported in the interview have to be rearranged in the holy arrangement of occurrence. The sequential analysis has to be based on this order of occurrence rather than the worldly course of the interview. The starting of a sequential analysis is not the analysis of opening of the conversation in the first interview, but the analysis of actions and events the interviewee reported as the earliest documents of the case history. The aim of other recent developments is to obtain interpretations of images from this approach. A consequence of this approach is that the sequential analytical procedure has developed into a program with clearly demarcated methodological steps. A further consequence of this is that it is made clear that subjective views provide only one form of access to social phenomena. Meaning is also produced at the level of the social. Finally, the idea of social sciences as textual sciences is preserved most consistently here. Another aspect is the call for conducting interpretations in a group in order to increase the variation of the versions and perspectives brought to the text and to the use the group to validate interpretations that have been made. Social science hermeneutics. Recent approaches have taken up basic ideas of objective hermeneutics but have developed a different understanding of hermeneutics and of the issues of research. They no longer use the term objective, focusing instead on the social interaction of knowledge. Again, non-standardized data protocols of interaction are preferred to interview data. The researchers should approach the field under study as naively as possible and collect unstructured data. Interpretations follow a three-step procedure. First, open coding according to Strauss is applied with a focus on the sequential structure of the document, line by line, sometimes word by word. Then researchers look for an extremely combined meaning units and concepts that tie together the parts and units. The third step seeks new data with which the interpretation is falsified, modified, and extended by means of the later data collection. Narrative and hermeneutic approaches take into account the structure of the text. The analysis follows the structure of the text sequentially and sees the statements in this context. Biographical texts are analyzed in the light of the sequence of the events that is reported so that the internal structure of the life history and the external structure of the life reported in it may be related to each other. Social science hermeneutics links such a sequential analysis with open coding according to grounded theory research. Friends, in this module, you have studied analysis of narrative interviews for reconstructing events, narrative data as life constructions, objective hermeneutics, further development, social science hermeneutics. Thanks for visiting EPG Pathshala.